Hey guys, we're talking about the limitlessness of God. The only reason God is limited at all is because of you and I. Why? Because he has chosen to co-labor with us to accomplish his will here on earth. And when you and I don't do what he tells us to do, we hinder him. We looked at Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 that says, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think according to the power that works in him. We then looked at the fact that he has an exceedingly abundant plan for our lives. We then looked and found out that he has an exceedingly abundant wisdom available to us. And then yesterday we looked and saw that he had exceedingly abundant anointing. We can walk in this anointing and do the things that Jesus told us to do. He said, go do the things that I did and more. Why? Because I go to be with the Father. He gives us that mantle of anointing abundantly above anything we can ask or think to go and get the job done. So he's equipped us in every way. So today I want to talk to you about exceedingly abundant provision. Now we know that God is called Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Amen. He is our provision. And if we look in 2 Corinthians chapter 9 and starting with verse 6, it says, but this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. He who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or out of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able, there it is again, God is able. Remember the last time we heard about God is able? He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, but it's only according to the power that works in us. Well, here God is able again. Listen to what he's able to do. God is able to make all grace, I can't find it, but I know it. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always, having all sufficiency in all things, will have an abundance for every good work. God is able to make all grace, grace is favor, abound. Abound means to increase greatly. So God is able to make all favor increase greatly towards you, so that you have all sufficiency in all things for every good work. Do you see that? Now, how does that come about, or how is God limited there? Well, first of all, if you give sparingly, you're going to reap sparingly. So you want to give bountifully so that you reap bountifully. But you also want to do it not grudgingly or out of necessity. In other words, if somebody says, man, I really need money. If you don't give me money, I'm going under. You better just let them go under, because the only reason that you need to give is so that you need to give with a cheerful heart and not out of necessity, but as you purpose in your heart. Amen. And so when we do that, when we become cheerful givers and we give bountifully and we give cheerfully, then God is able to make all grace abound towards us, that we always, having all sufficiency in all things, will have an abundance for every good work. There's also another amazing thing about this. If you look down two more passages, you'll find out that the Bible says that God gives seed to the sower and multiplies the seed sown. So even the seed that you do have to sow doesn't belong to you. He gave you the seed to sow, but then he multiplies the seed when it's sown. Notice he doesn't multiply the seed, he multiplies the seed sown. When you sow that into somebody else's life, when you finally make the decision to give cheerfully and not out of necessity, but cheerfully with a cheerful heart, God then multiplies the seed. You guys, are you getting this? God does exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or think. God makes all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things. I can't tell you enough about these scriptures and how powerful they are. Listen, he is Jehovah Jireh, my provider. And by the way, that speaks, and I've told you this before, that speaks of not just that he provides, but he is provision. So if he lives on the inside of you, which he tells us he does, he takes up his abode within you if you do his commandments, right? It comes from John chapter 14. So here you have provision living on the inside of you. If you have provision on the inside of you, then you can't lack. Okay, it's like light and dark. If you have light, you can't have dark. because dark can't exist in the presence of light. Lack can't exist in the presence of provision. So God is provision. He's Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Hallelujah. So he gives us abundantly, above all that we ask or think, exceedingly abundant provision. I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek him and serve him.